What's up everyone, my name is Aditya and welcome to HD Tech. Well guys, recently, if you have been following all of the Samsung related news, then you might be familiar that Samsung is making some really concrete decisions. Well guys, first of all, if you don't know, then let me tell you that guys, every year we know that Samsung launches their S lineup, which is the S series, and later the year, they launch their Note lineup. But in this particular year, Samsung has done a concrete decision. Well guys, after the S21 Ultra, now you're not going to be seeing the Note 21 Ultra. Well guys, they are directly going to be launching the Note phone next year. So their statement is like the Note series is very much popular. So from last 10 years, they are making the Note devices. So now they feel, you know, every year we have to focus on, you know, two devices. And the gap between the S lineup and the Note lineup is pretty much shrinking. And guys, that's the reason. Like now they are going to be launching the Note smartphone after 1.5 years or after 2 years. But the thing is, this year, the S21 Ultra is the best flagship by Samsung, and the Note 21 or the Note 22 will come next year. Well guys, straight away speaking, this might be a little bit depressing, but Samsung is having an absolutely awesome plan. Well, every year, around July or August, Samsung launches their foldable series. Well guys, the first generation Samsung Galaxy Fold was pretty much an experiment. Well guys, they wanted to be the first company to make a foldable form factor, and that was pretty much a success. But later, the last year's Samsung Galaxy Fold 2 is the best version of a foldable smartphone. Well guys, nowadays, we are seeing few foldable devices. But there is no other company than Samsung which is giving such a huge importance, so it is good to see. But the thing is, with the upcoming Samsung Galaxy Fold 3, things are going to be changing completely. Well guys, still today, you would have seen different form factors like a, you know, dual screen foldable technology or even a flip screen. But now, you are talking about triple foldable device. Well guys, there are going to be total 2 hinges. It is going to be, you know, a very different form factor. You're talking about literally a 16:9 aspect ratio complete monitor. Well, it is pretty much crazy to imagine. But the thing is, Samsung is going to be making a triple sandwich smartphone. So first of all, the first side you have to open from the top, and the second side you have to open from the bottom. So it is going to be a triple sided phone. First of all, it is very hard to imagine how you will carry this smartphone, because already with the current foldable technology, it is having the thickness of 2 potential smartphones. And just imagine, if you will carry literally 3 type of smartphones, then it will be such a huge pain. Well guys, I'm definitely curious for the overall ergonomics. But other than that, if we'll talk about this particular idea, then it makes way more sense. Well guys, see, the main reason for a foldable form factor is to fit a bigger display in a smaller form factor. But with this kind of triple fold mechanism or 3 surfaces, you're literally talking about replacing a full size tablet. Well guys, let me know in the comment section what are your thoughts about this particular technique. Right off the get-go, it is ridiculous to even imagine the future possibilities. But the thing is, the main overall usage and the form factor is a really big problem. Well guys, for starters, the current foldable tech, it is pretty much, you know, heavy. Well, first of all, you're talking about the weight of 2 smartphones. So if you're having the Samsung Galaxy Fold 1 or Fold 2, then you will be familiar that it is very much bulky. It literally feels that you're carrying a TV remote. And just imagine, if there will be 3 layers sandwiched together, then the amount of thickness will be completely ridiculous. So this is a particular aspect where Samsung needs to work behind. But other than that, if you are talking about 3 slabs of technology, then of course, you know, Samsung can implement the S Pen in the Fold device. And as I said earlier, that this year, Samsung is not going to be making the Note device. So it is pretty much clear that with the upcoming Samsung Galaxy Fold, you're going to be seeing the S Pen. Well guys, you might argue that everybody feels that Samsung should keep making all of their Note devices. But you have to look from the company's perspective. Already, the difference between their S lineup and their Note lineup is shrinking. The difference is only of the S Pen. And if so, like if this is the condition, then Samsung can put, you know, full research and development behind only one device. So that's the reason. From now on, they are going to be giving as much as importance possible towards their S lineup and towards their, you know, the Fold lineup. But the thing is, Samsung also wants to make the foldable technology accessible. Well, if you are not familiar, then already Samsung has made over 10 million units of the Samsung Galaxy Fold 2, and with the Fold 3, it is only going to get more. So the reality is, You know, believe me or not, but Samsung is trying its level best to make the foldable technology exciting. Well, with the help of this video, I just wanted to say that this year, Samsung is not going to be launching their new Note lineup. So next year, we will see the new successor. But speaking of this particular year, the Samsung's Fold 3 is going to be a major redesign. You're going to be talking about a completely new, you know, dual hinge foldable. So guys, let me know in the comment section, what are your thoughts on these particular issues? And guys, please, if you have watched this video till the end, then definitely click the subscribe button because it motivates me a lot to make more of this kind of videos. So guys, I will meet you with another beautiful video, and till then, peace.